Hi viewer, I welcome you to Edin TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through geography from one lesson number 10. The topic it is weather. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudoni. Welcome. We are going to look at today's lesson goals, where now we look at the elements of weather. That is the continuation from where we left. So we are going to look at the element of the weather, that is wind. That is what we'll be talking about today. Now, what is wind? The first question you're supposed to ask yourself, it is, what is this wind? Wind, it is the moving air. When the air moves in the atmosphere, then we can say that is wind. How does wind move? Or how does air move? Air will move from high pressure belt to the low pressure belt. So there must be that state where now we have the high pressure and the low pressure in order for the air to move. Now, there are a number of types of the wind. We have the land and sea breeze. We also have the cantabatic and anabatic winds. We have the chinook winds, the Amatan winds, the monsoon wind. All these winds will influence the weather in a way and another way. So they bring in the effect to the weather in a given time. Let us look at this type of the wind and see their characteristics and how they influence the weather. Now, we start by looking at the sea breeze. What causes the sea breeze, how it takes place, how it influences the weather. It is caused by difference in the atmospheric pressure. Remember, we have said there must be the high pressure belt and low pressure belt. So there must be that atmospheric difference. So this one, it is caused when there is a difference in both the land and the sea. But it is commonly in areas which are just adjacent to the sea or to the ocean or to the water body. Now, the time when the sea breeze takes place, we happen to have the land as a low pressure belt, while the sea as the high pressure belt. That is the reason as to why the wind will blow from the sea to the land. That is the reason as to why we refer to it as the sea breeze. Also, there must be the difference in temperatures between the land and the sea air. This is where now we have the land is warmer than the sea. And since now it is warmer than the sea, you get that it air become lighter. So it rises up. So the cold air from the sea will come and occupy that space that has been created by the warm rising air. And that's how the sea breeze will take place. This is the sea breeze. It is the movement of cool air from the sea to the land during the day. It takes place during the day. How is it formed? During the day, the land heats faster than the sea, because now the soil is a good conductor than the water, conductor of it. The air over the land rises, while the cooler air from the sea blows towards the land till it breaks. The rising air. The cool air from the sea is what is referred to as the sea breeze, that are blowing from the sea to the land. What are its effects to the weather? You get that it lowers the high temperatures on the land. So the high temperatures on the land are cold. And also, it ends up giving us the convectional rainfall, which is one of the precipitation. That is how it looks like. You can be able to see that the warm air is rising, and then we are going to the cooler air, which now is seen where now we have the cool air coming to occupy the space, that vacuum space. Let us go to the land breeze. Land breeze, it is the movement of cold air from the land to the sea at night. It is opposite of the sea breeze. How is it formed? During the night, the sea is relatively warmer than the land, since the land loses heat faster. The air over the water, being warmer, rises while the cooler, dense air from the land flows in to replace the rising air. And then it causes the land breeze. This is because the air will blow from the land to the ocean. In that case, now we are referring to it as the land breeze. High pressure on the land, while low pressure on the sea. This is how it is. High pressure on the land and low pressure on the sea. And that's how it moves. The next type of the wind, it is the anabatic wind. They are called local winds, which blow from the very bottoms. I can see this one is blowing from the very bottoms, up the valley to the top of the hill. And it occurs during the day. This is how it takes place. From the valley to the top. Then we go to the cantabatic winds. These are the cold local winds, which blow downhill from the hilltops or the mountaintops to the valley. And it occurs at night. So it is opposite of the anabatic winds. Anabatic winds will take place during the day, while cantabatic takes place at night. Now the other local winds that we talk about, it is the fawn winds. It occurs in winter in southern Europe. It descends from the Swiss Alps into the Switzerland. They blow northwards and they are warm. That's how the rocks work. Then we have the planetary winds. Planetary winds, there are a number of them. You have the trade winds, that is the southeast trade winds and the northeast trade winds. Then we also have the westerly winds, the polar eastery winds. We have them like that. And they look like that. Then we have the chinook winds. It looks like that. It blows from the cold, prevailing wind blows from the area where we have the rift to the area where we have the dry wind. Then we have the monsoon wind, and this takes place during the winters and summers. So you can see the way they are blowing. It takes place where we have the Himalayas and also where we have the Indian Ocean. Then we have the factors that influence the wind direction and the wind speed. We have the pressure gradient, that is from high pressure to the low pressure. Then Coriolis force, centrifugal force, this is the one that is responsible for the shape of the earth. And then the effect of the friction. Now let us look at the Coriolis force, how it operates. You can be able to see that in the northern hemisphere, it moves towards the light-hand side, while in the southern hemisphere it moves in the left-hand side. That's how the Coriolis effect are. As it marks the end of our lesson, I'm giving the activity. We have stated four local types of the wind, and then with an end of diagram, show the planetary wind, how they occur. For more information, visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 1. Then for more information, you can contact us through the SMS, through the YouTube, through the Facebook, and also you can Twitter us through that. Otherwise, stay tuned to the Erin TV.